Welcome into the Cowboys Report. I am Tom Downey as the Cowboys get another one. The Cowboys take down the New York Football Giants 44-20 in impressive fashion in this one as the Cowboys, a bit of a slow start, to be fair. Only 3 points in the first quarter, excuse me, but they end up dropping 44 in this one. Dak Prescott throws for 300-plus yards. Zeke Elliott goes for over 110. And the Dallas Cowboys, very importantly, I might add, improve to 4-1. Only through 5 games of the season, already a 2-game lead in the NFC East. They look like, folks, by far the best team in the division. That's a big deal for the Cowboys. Now, to be fair, and I know Giants fan producer Marshall is triggered by this, the Giants were hit very hard by injuries in this one. But despite losing Daniel Jones, Saquon Barkley, Kenny Galladay, not having Andrew Thomas, Sterling Shepard, Darius Slayton, I want to remind everybody of this. All you can do if you are a good football team against a bad football team is blow them out. And the Cowboys have done that now against the Giants and the Eagles. That's what matters. They're not, you know, squeaking by fourth quarter luck game-winning field goal like they used to do. The Cowboys are blowing out bad teams. Dak Prescott was slow to start in this game, by the way. He finished, however, with a pretty awesome stat line. 22 of 32, 302 yards, 3 touchdowns, 1 interception, which, by the way, was a great defensive play by Lorenzo Carter. But I do want to mention this. The Cowboys and Dak in this game did have too many mistakes. And I've mentioned this before. I want to mention it again. It feels to me like the only way this Cowboys team gets beat is if they beat themselves against this level of competition. That, in the end, is a good thing. Now, Dallas did let the Giants hang around. This was a one-score game into the second half. And then the Cowboys offense clicked, and Mike Glennon went full Mike Glennon. He's not a franchise QB. We know this. This is a game the Cowboys should blow him out. And they did. So I want to emphasize that the blowout happened. And that's a key takeaway for America's team. So I want you guys right now to grade the Cowboys in Week 5. A, B, C, D, or F. Get your votes in for me in the comment section. No wrong answer. Just be objective. Be honest for me. A, B, C, D, or F. Let's talk now about Zeke Elliott. He did not have a run longer than 15 yards. And despite that, he went for 21 carries, very limited usage in the fourth quarter because, again, the game was over. 110 yards. 1 touchdown, also chipped in a receiving touchdown of 4 yards on top of that. The Cowboys, again, ran for over 200 yards of offense. 110 from Zeke Elliott and 75 from Tony Pollard, who got a lot of the fourth quarter work because, again, this game was over pretty early. 14 carries, 75 yards from Pollard. He also chipped in, by the way, 4 catches. For 28 yards. As rare as this is, the Cowboys, folks, have 2 backs who are sustainable and producing well against lesser competition. And that was the case again for the Dallas Cowboys against the New York Giants. They get a massive win, and the offense again looks like it can only be stopped by themselves. Now, who here wants a free jersey? I'm sure many of you guys do. Here's how you can get one. Step one, sign up and deposit at least $100 with our sportsbook partner, BetUS. Head over to chatsports.com/bet. You see that link right there, bottom of your screen. Also, utilize promo code COWBOYS125. When you put down at least $100, you will get, my friends, a 125% deposit bonus. So 100 in, boom, extra 125 for free. Keep betting on Dallas undefeated against the spread this year. So again, chatsports.com/bet, promo code Cowboys125. Don't forget those two things. And because the Cowboys won, and I'm feeling good about this team, we hook you up with a Cowboys jersey. Two available options. CeeDee Lamb, who we'll get to in a minute on today's show, and the aforementioned Zeke Elliott, who looks back in the two styles for both players that you just saw. The navy, and I love the stars on the shoulders. So fresh, so clean. Email us, jersey@chatsports.com. If you guys have questions or concerns or whatever, we will give you the details. We'll need your BetUS account number, since your first bet, blah, blah, blah. But just email us, jersey@chatsports.com, if you guys want in on that deal. Let's talk receivers now. The Cowboys' offense continues to be a spread-the-ball-around attack. Amari Cooper only had 6 targets. He pulled in 3 of them. There were a couple throwaways mixed in there. 60 yards and a score. Meanwhile, his running mate, CeeDee Lamb, had 4 catches for 84 yards and a touchdown. A very good showing out of Lamb. He also, by the way, before I forget, chipped in 1 carry for 4 yards. The Cowboys haven't done it yet, but that little angle route out of the backfield, cut it inside against the linebacker, it's in the playbook. It's going to happen. I am sure of it. I also want to spend time talking about Dalton Schultz, because Schultz has been a good production, worrisome tight end. Finished today, 6 catches, 79 yards. The Giants can't stop tight ends. We know that, but it's not great if you are the Cowboys. That is, at some level, a bit of a red flag. Now, Schultz got some work in the run game. He's good in that area. There are times he's going like this. He catches the football, and he's holding it like this because he doesn't want to fumble. That's fine, but it always makes me worried in the end. Before we get to the defensive side of the ball, and I think there are no wrong answers. Plus an update, by the way, on Lael Collins coming up momentarily. Who was the MVP in Week 5 for the Dallas Cowboys? Was it Dak Prescott, Zeke Elliott, Trevon Diggs, who we'll get to here in a little bit? Get your votes in for me right now in the comments section. Let's talk now about Lael Collins, the Cowboys' right tackle. The judge in this one, for the background, let me back up. Lael Collins filed a lawsuit in a Texas court against the NFL saying his suspension was unfair, and he was filing for an emergency injunction. By the way, the judge in this case is the exact same judge as Ezekiel Elliott way back when he filed his own lawsuit against Roger Goodell in the NFL. Now, the judge did not rule in this case this week. He basically asked the defense, like, hey, is Collins going to play? And Collins' defense was like, no, probably not. So the judge said, okay, I'll take my time then, since the hearing was on Friday. If Collins wins, I think a judge, A, is going to rule Monday or Tuesday, maybe Wednesday, probably not, though. I think it's early this upcoming week. If Collins wins, he can come back a game early. The suspension will likely be held off until next year. And, oh, by the way, his guarantees, injury-wise, for this upcoming year, do get reinstated. Now, as things sit right now, the Cowboys were right to go with Terrence Steele. He's been a good player for the Cowboys. Now, there are still reps out there. You go, oh, yeah, that's why he's not as good as Lael Collins. A couple of those today against the Giants. That's a bit of a red flag. But he's much cheaper. I still think Collins, ignoring the contract, is a better player. So I'm very curious here how you guys vote. Type TS for you want to start Terrence Steele whenever Collins comes back, or type in LC for you want to roll with Lael Collins. Get your votes in for me right now in the comments section. Another week, another Trevon Diggs INT. He picked off one, broke up. I think I had him at 2 other pass breakups. I think ESPN had him at 1 other one because INTs count as PBUs. There was the one sideline out of bounds, like unreal grab by Diggs. I had him as 2 other breakups beyond that one. Either way, Diggs did it again. His 6th interception in 5 games. He has tied Don Bishop as the only 2 Cowboys players in franchise history to get interceptions in the team's first five games. Don Bishop, by the way, did that in 1961. I was far from born at that point. That's how long ago it was. The Cowboys, nine straight games with two-plus takeaways. Trevon Diggs, folks, unquestionably deserves to be among the front runners to win Defensive Player of the Year. Six INTs in five games, something like 10 pass breakups. Obscene production. Opposing teams, please, please keep throwing at Diggs. He's been baiting quarterbacks, and it continues to work. If you guys want daily Cowboys videos, plus some overreactions, or the Lael Collins breaking news, one of the two, if not both, tomorrow, hit that big red button and subscribe. Daily Cowboys videos. In fact, more than just one Cowboys video a day between the boys and girls show as well here. But subscribe. We're free here at the Dallas Cowboys Report. Wanted to go hit two more defensive players here, kind of rapid fire. Micah Parsons led the team in tackles with eight, had three quarterback hits. Odighizuwa had a free sack, the only one of the day because Mike Glenn had a bad snap, so he took one. I'll take it either way. Parsons, early on with Daniel Jones out there, was spying Jones, and it worked very, very well. I like his use. More off-ball linebacker today, but it worked for the Cowboys. Now, Jabril Cox in the stat sheet had one tackle. He did not play that much, but that tackle was huge. It was the naked bootleg with Daniel Jones on a quarterback sneak at the goal line on third and goal. And he rocked Jones. Now, I did not think there was anything, full stop, dirty, about that play from Cox. Daniel Jones dropped his head. That's the end result. That's supposed to be never called, which I agree with. It should never be called. But it is technically a penalty for dropping your helmet as a runner. I don't care. That's not should not be a call. Cox, though, many of you pointed out in our live show, I don't know, in the end, if Jalen Smith makes that play. So here are, before we go, the NFC East standings. Dallas, 2-3. Washington falls to the Saints, or Dallas, 4-1. God damn myself, Washington is 2-3, excuse me. Philadelphia, they somehow beat Carolina. Hurts was garbage for the first half and then woke up. Maybe that's some play-calling issues. Philadelphia, 2-3. And then the G-Men, 1-4, as the Cowboys get a huge win over the New York Football Giants, 44-20. A massive win in this one for the Dallas Cowboys. They needed it. And in the end, when you're doubling up the opponent, even if it's not always perfect along the way, that means you're doing something right if you're the Cowboys.